Let's pray together.
Father,
we thank you for this day.
A
day your people have been waiting for.
We're
praying, the Lord, you'll bless everyone in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Let this be the day of power. The day of wonders. The day of healing. The day of miracles. The day of salvation. And the day of total freedom for everyone in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray tonight you open the windows and the doors of heaven.
May your news on a window can you bring
shower your miracles upon your people in Jesus' name. And all our brothers and sisters and friends and neighbors who are hearing anywhere in Nigeria, in Africa, outside Africa, oh Lord, I pray there'll be a mighty visitation tonight. Make it a special day for everybody. Thank you, Lord, because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. We can sit down. I'm reading from John chapter 8. And I'm reading from verse 32. And then verse 36. John chapter 8, verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
He
says, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. There are some things we know, and they don't matter. There are some information we hear, and the information does not matter. There is a kind of instruction we have. They say this is truth, but the truth does not matter much.
There is a kind of instruction we have.
There is a particular truth. The truth of the gospel. The truth of grace. The truth of the gospel of the Lord. The good news. The truth about the love of God for you. When we know that truth of what God has for you. When we know that truth of what Jesus has provided for you, that truth will set you free. You are here for freedom tonight. Do you know there are two sides of any coin? When you look at a coin, you have one side, you have the other side. The other side of the coin is this. If all you know is a lie, that lie will bind you. Satan tells you a lie. And you shall know a lie from the devil, and the lie will bind you up. Hey, God does not love you. You've gone too far. You are a terrible sinner. And that lie concerning God that Satan is telling you will bind you up. He's blessing other people. You cannot be blessed. It's a lie. If you give your mind and give your heart to a lie, the lie will bind you up. It will hold you in a dungeon of darkness. Other people say the power is in the sea, the power is in the sky, the power is in a shrine somewhere. It's a lie. If you give your mind and give your heart to the lie, it will bind you up and bind you up. You will seek and seek and seek. When the light of the good news shines into your dungeon, when the Lord turns in the light of revelation, and then you know the truth, God loves me, Jesus died for me, Jesus does not want me to suffer, He does not want me to suffer here, He does not want me to suffer in eternity. The Lord is smiling at me. He says, I created you. I love you. I want to help you. I want to do for you anything you want me to do for you to make you happy here and happy over there.
I want to make you happy here and happy.
When you know the truth of the good news, ye shall know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Tonight I come to tell you that your freedom is near. I said your freedom is near. I want to talk to you tonight on the wonder of freedom through Christ. The wonder of freedom through
Christ.
Look at verse 36.
John
chapter 8, verse 36. If the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. The wonder of freedom through Christ. Three things we're going to look at. Number one, true freedom from all sins. True freedom from all sins. Number two, total freedom from all sicknesses. The Lord has seen you there tonight. Those tears will be dried up tonight. Number three, this is wonderful. Number three, wonder of all wonders. Number three, say wonderful. Can I hear you? Number three now, your freedom will not be late. I said your freedom will not come late. Timely freedom. Tonight is your night. I said tonight is your night. Timely freedom from Satan. Satan has been there with all his demons, with all his evil spirits. You feel him in your body. You feel his fire in your brain. You feel all his pinching in your skin. You see him during the day, he will not allow you to rest. At night you want to sleep, he has come. All his personalities, all his messengers, they come. Oppression, attack, affliction. Praise the Lord tonight. Timely freedom from Satan.
Jesus,
you will be free. Finally, your freedom has now come. Number one, true freedom from all sins. I want to tell you something. Nobody likes to be sinning. Nobody enjoys sinning. Actually, when God created us, he made us like himself. Like Father, like Son. Like Father, like his children. Everybody likes to be good. Everybody likes to be nice. Everybody likes to walk upright and walk straight. When you do something good, and somebody says, thank you. Those words, thank you, they are sweet. Everybody likes to do something good and do something pleasant, do something nice, so that we can say, thank you, my friend. Thank you, my neighbor. But because Satan doesn't want us to feel happy, the good things we want to do, we cannot do them. And anytime we do things we don't like to do, there is sorrow in our heart. There is regret in our heart. There is remorse. We are not ourselves. All those things that we do against our own will, they make us look stupid, look shameful, and they make us look like we are not good people. That's why I will say, I won't do that again. Because when I do them, they make me unhappy. When I go there, it makes me shameful. So I say, never, never. I will not do nothing anymore. But there is something, it is greater than we are. It is stronger than we are. Look at Romans chapter 7. I'm reading from verse 15. Romans chapter 7, verse 15. For that which I do, I allow not. For what I would, that I do not. But what I hate, that I do. I don't want to do them. I don't want to say something like that. I don't want to touch something like that. I'm a dignified man. I'm a respectable woman. That is not my personal choice. That is not me. There is something else controlling the man. Something else controlling the woman. As he said, I must be free. I will not continue like this. He tries and tries and tries. And yet he is not able to set himself free. The more he tries, the more he is bound. So he said, Look at me now. What can I do now? Look at verse 16. If then I do that which I would not, I consent unto the law that the law is good. Now in verse 17. Now then, it is no more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me. When somebody says, you are a sinner, say, yes, I know. If you knew the effort I am making, if you knew how I am struggling to be free, you will not be accusing me like that. I don't like to do it. It is no more I that do it. It is sin that dwells in me. Anyone you see, they may use bold face in the afternoon. When you say, my friend, how can you do something like this? Already he is feeling condemned. He is feeling unhappy. I don't like to do this. I don't like to touch this. A man like me drinking and then falling in the gutter, this is shameful. I don't want to do this. But all you accuse him, he will just use small face. What's your business there? Am I the only one doing something like that? He's only putting forth that front so that you leave him alone. He said, I'm already unhappy. And this man is coming to tell me that this is not good. He's making me more sad. That's why he's talking like that. But inside everyone, we want to be good. That thing you could not do for yourself, Jesus has come to do it for you tonight.
That's
why he says in verse 24, O wretched man that I am, who shall deliver me from this body of death? If you call him wretched, he'll say, don't talk to me like that. If the preacher points at him, you are a wretched man, he said, why are you preaching like that? If his neighbor or friend points to him, a wretched man, he'll say, me you are calling wretched, he will not accept. But deep in his own soul, in his heart of hearts, because of the inward internal shame he feels within himself, he says, this is bad. This is dirty. This is evil. When nobody is there, he tells himself, O wretched man that I am, who shall deliver me from this body of death? He says, this thing will kill me. This thing will bring HIV into my... This thing will kill me. This thing will eventually take my life. Wretched man that I am. Wretched woman that I am. Wretched boy that I am. Wretched girl that I am. Who shall deliver me? That's why I came to give you the good news. Are you ready for good news? If the Son shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed.
His
name is Jesus.
Jesus.
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son,
that
whosoever believes in him will not perish. You will not perish. This sin will not kill you. Your deliverer will come to you. Your savior will reach you.
Jesus,
whosoever believes in him will not perish, but will have everlasting life. Look up here. I will not perish. How about you? Say it for yourself now.
See,
Jesus is there, you will not perish. Jesus has died for you, you will not perish. On the cross, he was hanging there for you, you will not perish. Cheer up, the Savior has come. Cheer up, your Redeemer has come. Who shall deliver me? Who shall deliver me? Who shall deliver me from this body of death? Jesus is the Savior. He has not come to condemn you. He came to save you. And tonight, as you come to the Lord, say, Jesus, I thank you. You have borne my pain. You bore my punishment. You are my Savior.
Jesus,
I come to you tonight. All your sins, he will forgive. He comes to set you free tonight. Are you there? Where are you? I said, he came to set you free tonight.
Freedom.
Freedom. It has come for you in Jesus' name. Number two. Total freedom from all sicknesses. If you are sick, you know how you want to be free. A sick person is like a dependent person. He cannot live his life free. He depends on other people. I am blind. Can you help me find this and lead me there? He's dependent on other people. I am lame, I want to go there, I cannot walk there. Can you carry me there?
Biko, akromunguro, atom kangefu no fesin koso, burume burubuga nebaho.
My back is bent, I cannot stand up, I cannot carry myself, I cannot even dress myself. Can you help me? There is fire burning in the brain, and you cannot think of, I want to go to market, I want to do business, I want to get money, I want to get this. The fire in the brain is your concentration. I want to be free. Why am I suffering like this? There is cancer, there is ulcer, there is tuberculosis. Instead of going to work, instead of taking care of your children, you are going to the hospital again.
Oria cancer na oria ibi na ngbungbu azode. Kabi ge ore ego gi zuo zinulo gi.
Other people that have committed crime, they go to the prison, they are there only for 6 months, only for 1 year. This person is sick, is bedridden, is either in the house 3 years or in the hospital 3 years. Do you see? A person like that is totally bound.
ohuju anya putakwa mana onya ore aturu yanga aru ito aru ino onu na otu ebe.
But now tonight that bad condition will change into something good in Jesus' name.
Manabalia, ono do juan kore di uteranandogi. Jesus.
With your own legs, you will walk. With your own eyes, you will see. With your own hands, you will write, you will dress yourself. All the affliction in your body tonight is your night. The name of Jesus will drive everything away in Jesus' name.
Aha, Jesus,
you will be free. I said you'll be free. Who am I talking about there? I said you'll be free. You brought your mama, mama will be free tonight. You brought papa, papa will be free tonight. This is my child. How about my child? You will rejoice over your child tonight. Freedom for everybody. And freedom from every sickness in your life. Jesus will heal you tonight. I'm looking at Matthew chapter 8. I'm reading from verse 16 and from verse 17. It says, when the evening was come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils, and he cast out the spirits with his word, and he healed how many people there now? All that were sick.
Mamboru anyasi hakutere ya ototo mmadu ndi mmojo ji.
Healed all that were sick.
All.
What does that mean? I am there. You are there. He is there. She is there. The lame is there. The blind is there. Paralytic there. Kidney problem there. Tuberculosis there. Cancer there. Ulcer there. All man there, woman there, boy wonderful, girl wonderful, oh, it's coming. I said it's coming. I see the healing coming your way. I see the miracle coming your way. It will happen in Jesus' name.
Jesus Christ.
He healed all that were sick, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, himself, not another person, himself took our infirmities and bare our sicknesses. Tonight I praise the Lord for you. The night of sickness has now turned to the day of healing. Your night of darkness has turned to the day of deliverance. There's joy tonight. I said there's joy tonight. The joy of receiving a miracle from the Lord. It has come. I said it has come. In Matthew chapter 12 verse 15. Matthew chapter 12 verse 15. But when Jesus knew it, he withdrew himself from thence, and great multitudes followed him, and he healed them all.
Jesus Maraya Osineba was going to Toto Madu Soya.
Do you see that he heals them all? He didn't say your own is too difficult. Stay aside, come another time.
He
didn't say your own was caused by ancestral whatever. I'll see you later. Come another time.
He didn't say
this one is too complicated. Okay, stay aside. I'll see you another time. No other time. I said no other time. This is the time. Healing, this is the time. Deliverance, this is the time. He healed them all. Are you part of that tonight? I said, are you part of that tonight? Matthew chapter 14. Matthew chapter 14. Reading from verse 14. Jesus went forth and saw a great multitude, and he was moved with compassion towards them, and he healed their sick.
Jesus went forth and saw a great multitude, and
he has not changed. He has not changed.
Jesus had
he has compassion. He has mercy. He has love. And he has been thinking about you. Thank God you came. Thank God you are there. There's going to be a divine connection tonight between you and Jesus, your healer.
Jesus
is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Jesus
did it before, he's doing it today. Number one, freedom from sin. Number two, freedom from sickness. Number three, timely freedom from satanic affliction, satanic attacks. If you know that your problem is caused by evil spirits, your problem is caused by that terrible devil, your adversary. Your problem is caused by demons in the day or in the night. Or it's occultic power coming from Satan tormenting your life. Your deliverance, your freedom is here tonight. When you hear that name, the name of
Jesus,
there is power in that name. There is authority in that name. It is that name that breaks every yoke. Your yoke is booking tonight. Praise the Lord, you're free. Free at last, free at last. After all these many years, free at last, free at last. After going here, going there, and you were still like that, praise the Lord, free at last, free at last. After so many years and so many days of tears, of sorrow, of suffering, of saying, will I die like this? Will I die like this? Praise the Lord, free at last, free at last. Tonight you will glorify God. There are signs and wonders happening here tonight. The wonder of salvation. The wonder of healing. The wonder of deliverance. The wonder of total freedom. The wonder of true freedom. And the wonder of timely freedom. Number one, there's true freedom waiting for you right now. Number two, there's total freedom waiting for you now. Number three, there's timely freedom waiting for you now. If you are the one here tonight going to receive heads bowed and eyes closed, heads bowed and eyes closed, you are telling the Lord tonight, salvation, 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 I want it now. I want it now. And Jesus wants to give it to you now. You are there, raise up your hands. I want salvation. Wonderful. Wonderful. You are there, I want salvation. Just raise up your hands. The deliverer has come. The one that will save you from your sin, he has come. The one that will take that load of sin away. Take that burden of sin away. Take the guilt of sin away. Take the condemnation of sin away. He is right there by your side. And you're saying, Lord, here am I. Raise up that hand. Let Jesus see that hand. Let the heavens see that hand. Let the Almighty God know that you want salvation. Raise up that hand now. As you raise up the hand, open your mouth and talk to the Lord. Say, Lord, I thank you. Open your mouth and tell the Lord. Open your mouth and tell the Lord. Obey me and send me to hellfire forever and ever. I thank you tonight, you have come to save me. Turn away from that sin. Say final bye-bye. Bye-bye forever. I will not go into those sins anymore. Lord, grant me the grace. The grace of salvation. The grace of eternal life. It's right there. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. It's right there. Believe and you are saved. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved. I'm praying for you now. Keep up that hand. Keep up that hand. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your love. Thank you for the love that brought salvation. Thank you for Jesus, your only begotten Son. He is the Savior. He is the Lord. And he brings forgiveness to everyone tonight.
Jesus,
he brings salvation to everyone tonight. Oh Lord, I pray. Everyone raising up their hands. Everyone repenting. Everyone turning to the Lord. Everyone believing on the Lord Jesus Christ. Forgive them now. Save them now. Change their lives now. Lord, I pray. All their sins will be totally forgiven and forgotten. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. They are free. They are saved. In Jesus' name we pray.
Jesus.
Put those hands together for Jesus. I want you to look at your body. Look at that sickness because you're seeing that thing for the last time. If you are blind, get ready to see. Your name, get ready to rise up and walk. One leg shorter than the other, you are limping. good time has come, God will straighten those legs. You brought anybody in chains, march, the time of deliverance has come for them. Incurable disease, this is the time for you to be healed. Just raise up one hand. Lay the other hand where you have a challenge. The Lord has come to heal you and to deliver you. I want you to hear the final amen. You'll check up yourself. You'll see you are free.
We're
ready now. Father, in the name of
Jesus,
we thank you because tonight is a night of freedom. Freedom for the sick. Freedom for the satanically oppressed. Lord, I pray tonight, stretch forth your mighty hand, heal your people in Jesus' name. Lord Jesus, will remain the same today as yesterday. Your power, your compassion will never change. In your love, in your mercy, in your compassion, touch your people, heal your people in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for everyone that this will be the moment of the miracle. That spirit of insanity, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. All the yoke, all the bondage, all the chains, all the fetters of the devil, I loose you now in the name of Jesus. Spirit of epilepsy, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who have any swelling in their body. Whatever sickness has caused that swelling, that swelling with the sickness and the pain will melt away right now. That big water head become normal in Jesus' name. Goiter, hunchback, I command you, vanish away in Jesus' name. Elephantiasis, be healed right now. Well, tumor, fibroid, be healed in Jesus' name.
But
I pray for those who have internal problems in their body. That kidney to come alive now. Those livers to come alive right now. Any internal bleeding to stop right now. The pain to come out right now. Lord, stretch forth your mighty hand upon all your people. Set them free in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who are blind. Blindness, you don't have any chance to remain there again. Cataract, you don't have any chance to remain there again. Glaucoma, you don't have any chance to remain there again. Lord, I pray for them. Touch their eyesight. Touch their eyesight. That blindness, that darkness, Come out in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who are lame, those who have stroke, power to come into your body, joy to come into your joints, life to come into those dead tissues in Jesus' name. I pray the healing virtues of the Lord Jesus will pass to everyone right now.
Heal me.
Deliverance. Lord, confirm it upon your people. Miracle everywhere now. To my right, to my left. To my front, in the middle, at the back. Anywhere, everywhere now. Miracle. Healing. Deliverance. Receive your miracle in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We know you have done it. In Jesus' name I pray.
Jesus Christ.
Praise the Lord, it's done. I said, praise the Lord, it's done.
Check
up yourself. Check up yourself. You are healed.
Jesus, you are
free. The miracle is there.
Amen.
Amen.
Tested God's miracle. My name is Mrs. Diligent Shukwemeka. I came from Imo State. I have 2 good years glaucoma in my eyes. I doesn't work under the light without glass. And the thing always cover my eyes. And another one, they said anxiety and fear entered into my brain. Every day the thing that will be dragging my vein back. But when I heard that daddy was coming, I heard it in the radio. I said I would not miss it. And God make a way for me. Thank God, today God has finally delivered me. I can walk now without glass. Just join me to glorify the name of the Lord. But I don't know how to adore this God.
Put your hands together for the Lord. 2 years of glaucoma. God of wonders has done it. Your own is waiting for you. Pick it by faith. And it is done. The next is fire.
But since the GSC video program here, many people are on your brother and come Kweba. Mandu pastors, Haman, Ebrum Gebe, and Kozo. Now, 2012, December, Kamwelo, and GSNs are from Bogota, they're present in Sanity. Where you can start and see since then, where Lota. Have Moyan and we're making an angle hogu. Take off one of the second name born on a task since 2 years. That your last. Praise the Lord.
Years of psychiatric problem God.
Ọ̀tụtụ afọ nsogbu nke ịyà ara na isi mgbaka ọ pụọ na.
The God of wonders has done it for her.
Chineke nke ọrụ ebe emewere ya.
He testified that even pastors here know of her case.
O kwuru na ndị ọzọ atụrụ n'ebe ala ha ma banyere ya.
They've carried her from place to place.
E bu ya si ebe a gaa ebe dị iche iche.
And God had done it for her.
Chineke emeworo ya.
God will do your own tonight.
Chineke ga-eme ka gị n'abalị a.
Just check up where you are.
Nene onwe gị ebe ahụ ị nọ.
You are the next to testify.
Gị ka o ruru ị na-akọ otito.
Because God of wonders is at work here.
N'ihi na Chineke ka ọrụ ebe na-arụ ọrụ n'ebe a.
Praise living God. Na m ekele Chineke ụmụnne m na ụmụnna m. Eva m bụ Mmerichukwu. Onye ọha ọzara. So ọ bụ mgbe onye isi anyị bịa na nke ọzọ n'Ọnịcha. E nwere ebe ntụgire mmadụ ihe wee nọ n'ebe ahụ enye m ụkwara. Ụkwara ahụ na-atụ m na ọbịa ụbọchị m obi. Ana m ehi ụra. Sị Chineke wote ka m chọrọ ịnwụ na mmere ebere soro mmadụ. So nwee relax n'ebe ahụ aghọtaghị m onwe m nọ ebe ọzọ nwere nọ onye chọọchị m. So anyị jecha ebe ahụ ụkwara ahụ wee dapụta. Chineke mgbe a mara sị a na-eduwo redi asị na GS na-abịa uwe si na Ọnịcha na ugwu Hausa mbụ wee gbadata Ọnịcha ihe niile a na-eme eso m emechaa ya mgbe ahụ ruo GS bịa ya ka ọ na ọbịbịa ya ọhụ bịara mgbe ahụ ka Chineke mere wepụ ụkwara maka amahadu mgbe ya bụ ụkwara ana m ene anya mgbe m ji na-esi anya na ịma ka ọ na ọdụ m amahụ ụkwara anawo ọdụ ha m ruo nta n'aha Jizọs. So ọ bụrụ na nke kwa ekwesị na adụ reti n'ebe nọ. So anọ m na ugwu Hausa ahụkwa ebe na-ekpere Chineke amam ebe nzọrọ ụkwụ mgbe anyị na-eje mmanya kraị abalị ụtụtụ wee se ọkpa n'ebe ahụ ọ bụrụ ebe ha debere ọgwụ sisi ahụ ọgwụ ahụ na-enye m nsogbu nna-asụ Chineke isi na ekpere na ebumọnụ ka eji achụ ụmụ ọjọ ife oge nna abịa na ekpere anọ m ebumọnụ bịa wee maka nna ekpere tere m ọ na-adụ m nọ dasdani fri ka nna anọ ọmọ n'ito ọmọdụ ọ bụrụ ọdụ m ka mkpere ekpere were ekpere ahụ sobi ya sịa na ọbịbịa ji ya sịa na ịdụ okwu ara eti m ga-enwekwara onwe m na o nweghị ihe ndụ ka ọzọ ana m etupu etupu ote enweghị mgbe m na-edebe ikpere m ote mkpuchi ikpere narị ọdụ ka mkpuchiri ya n'osisi mana naa onye isi anyị m bịara ugo anawa afụcha m bịara kwuo okwu megide ekwesị na nrịanrịa ya wee si n'ahụ m pụọ. Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Our mother testified how the Lord healed her body pains, everything on her body. Before she could not bend, she could not rise up. She even told her that she had sleepless nights. But the Lord has healed her now. She can bend, she can stand. All the pains and all the things that blocked on her system, the Lord has removed everything. Praise the Lord.
Put your hands together for the Lord.
Kwara Jesus ayaka.
Put your hands together for the Lord.
Kwara Jesus ayaka.
The more you clap, the more your miracle.
Eke ga niru na akwa ko ru ebe gi ya na ga niru.
Check up your own body. Check up your own body.
Na aro nke gi.
The miracle is there.
Oru ebe ahụ na ebe ahụ ịnọ.
You are not a spectator.
Ebugo onye bịara nkiri na
anọ. You must be a partaker of this blessing.
Ị ga abụ onye ga-eketa ngọzi a.
Next is fire.
Praise Lord. N'eziokwu ụmụnne na ụmụnna m, ihe Chineke mere m, ọ dị m ihe ịtụnanya. N'eziokwu abụ m onye na nna di anwapụta Chineke ihe ọ na-arụ. Ihe emewela nri kemgbe otu ọnwa na ụma, mana eji m ekpere were na-achụ ya. Ihe bịara nnọọ bịa kpuchie m anya bịa na-afụ m n'obi na-asị o nwere ihe m riri wee na-ekpe ekpere na-agwa Chineke okwu maka anụ m adabere n'ebe Chineke nọ anụ m adabere dị n'ebe ọgwụ nọ ekpegidere m ekpere okwe dị m nji wee jee chọọ ọgwụ wee bido na-aṅụ ọgwụ ibiri ndụ n'abalị ekpekọtara m ekpere obi a n'azụ m adịka ihe na-agbọwa agbọwa daa n'ala nọ n'ala ahụ nọ n'ọkwa na-ekpe ekpere na-atụ wugharị onwe m o ji njiri gwa ụmụnna m so ngwa ebe ha mara distrikti na-asị na pastọ Okumuyi na-abịa So akwụkwọ ahụ ka m ji eto onye mmiri ya nọ na moto ahụ ya were si m pụta si m lekwa headquarter deeper life mmiri tụọ na ha ji akpọrizi m ebe a ewere nri tụọ ewere kpọrọ m bịa ebe a ọ mgbe a na-ekpezi ekpere ibi ndụ mgbe anyị na-eme nne eji anyị m adagharị ewere ruo m ga na-ekpe ekpere ruo m ga na-ekpe ekpere ewere kpere ekpere chineke were pastọ okumunyi were kpara ngwa ọrụ so onye ọbụla bikwasị aka dị ebe ọ na-enye ya nsogbu chile welie aka elu ewee kpewe ekpere ekpecha ihe m nwere ụka ihe n'ikwu ya ọpụrụ pụrụ n'obi obi m adị klia isi m adị klia anya m ị na-asaghasịa praise lord
put your hand together for the lord
chineke anyị aka
triple miracle
ọrụ ebe atọ
glaucoma removed
anya ihu ruru ihu ewepụrụ ya
pains on the head removed.
Ihe mgbu n'isi ya ewepụrụ ya.
Pains all over the body gone.
Ihe mgbu n'arụ ya niile ha.
God of wonders has done it.
Chineke nke ọrụ ebe emeela ya.
Another testifier.
Onye ọzọ.
Praise the Lord. Aha m bụ Pauline Nwabeze. Esi m na ndọ wee bịa. So mgbe m rutere ebe a, arụ adịrọ m mma. Enwe m ọsa since 1983. Ma ọtụtụ ibe ndị ọzọ na-emegachasị m bete na dịka m rutere ebe a mgbe na-ekpe ekpele si onye ọbụla ebiri aka ebe ibe na-eme ebidoro m aka n'ebe ibe na-eme m wenye aka nke ozi elu ka ekpechasịrị ekpele achọrọ m ibe ndị ama bụrụ ọzịa praise the lord
our sister has been suffering from ulcer since 1983 but when she came here the man of God said raise your hand and anywhere you're having any problem I'm going to pray for you so after the prayer all the pains of us and everything has disappeared. Put your hands together for the Lord.
A God of wonders is at work.
Chineke nke ọrụ ebe na-arụ ọrụ.